Hey you, in this video I want to talk about how can you become a self-taught developer. This idea came from this recent video I made called The Biggest Mistake Programmers Make. On that video, Chris Hawks posted a comment and he said, I'm a self-taught developer, and Chris Hawks, by the way, also has his own YouTube channel and is teaching lots of people, which is super cool. And he goes, I'm a self-taught developer and I've taught probably millions at this point. I've never used video tutorials for learning. I think you have to get out of the books, tutorials, your own head, and just start writing code. So I'm gonna talk about how you can become a self-taught developer, my thoughts on that comment. So without any further ado, let's jump right into it.
I've always wanted to put my own ad at the start of my video and at the end of my video, so this is gonna be super awesome. But I have a special announcement and I do wanna say this. I've been planning to put this together for a really long time. It's finally come together and it's an unbelievable program. I'm gonna talk more about it at the end. I have something very special for you, okay? If you've ever wanted to make your first $1,000 from programming, coding, all right? If you ever wanted to learn how you can freelance and start earning an income from this, if you ever wanted to learn how you could 10x your productivity, learn the tools, strategies, and frameworks to take your skills to the next level, and learn how to freelance with it, learn how to have more time, money, impact on this world, okay? If you wanted to be able to do all of those things, well, I have a thing for you. I'm gonna put that at the end of this video. Enjoy this video, you're gonna love it. And at the end, I'm gonna show you what are the steps you need to take to jump on this thing. Let's do this.
All right, this is Kazi, also known as Papa Python from cleverprogrammer.com. It helps a lot if you're watching this video, if you could just hit the like button. It helps out the channel a lot. I'm trying to be as active as possible. This is day 11 of the coding challenge that I am doing. So this is video 11 out of 30. And if you want to follow me along in this journey of where I'm doing a video every single day, you can follow me along and say code for 10 minutes or 30 minutes a day. It could be something simple like that. And you can follow me at Clever Kazi on my Instagram to see more of the behind the scenes. And you can also tag me, like go, hey, at Clever Kazi, and then like hashtag 30 day challenge, and I'll repost you. So that way we can keep each other accountable. It's not so much to grow my Instagram, which, you know, it is helping when you guys jump on. But what I realized is Instagram is really this amazing habit building tool that I use for myself. So I want to inspire other people to use it as well. Like you can see, I'm tracking my gym, I'm tracking my daily log, I'm tracking my videos. And if I code, I'll even track that too. All right, so moving on, let's talk about how you can become a self-taught developer and my thoughts on Chris Hawks' comment. So basically Chris Hawks saying like, yo, you have to stop looking at tutorials and books and relying on something. This goes pretty much hand in hand with the video, with the last video that I made where somebody commented on that video and was like, yeah, if I wanna write 500 lines of code, you know, I can build a calculator app and I know a lot of C and C++, but if it comes to making sorting algorithms or something like that, or I have to write a 500 lines of code, he's so proud of himself and he's like, nah, I can't do that. I'll wait till I get those courses. So I'm against that. And Chris Hawks, it seems like, is also a little bit against that concept. What Chris is encouraging people to do is, yo, get off your ass and start actually working on a project or your own coding thing. Because tutorials are gonna help you, but they're not gonna help you make the things that you wanna make. And as you're building the project that you're building, then you can actually go back and look up those certain things. So then if you get stuck on, let's say your app needs to have some kind of sorting algorithm to show people based on their, like, in an alphabetical order, or it needs to show people based on their, like, follower accounts. You know, if you're making a Twitter clone or an Instagram clone and you want to have like a leaderboard of who has the most followers, then you need some kind of like sorting algorithm, and that's a very basic one, right? So then you can still go and learn that tutorial. As soon as you learn, you can come and apply. That's how each concept is gonna be internalized. It's gonna be beyond just this superficial level of understanding. And I know in the last few videos, I've been hammering this point home. There's a reason, because it's that important. If you wanna become a self-taught developer, the terrible way of doing it is just hoping you can keep learning and learning and learning and learning and learning, and then one day you dream you're gonna be ready for something, right? Let me challenge you to something. How many of your own projects have you built so far? If your answer is like very few, less than say 5 or 3, like your own projects, There's a reason why you're not improving at the level you want to improve at. There's a reason why you might be stuck where you're stuck. There's a reason why you feel like you see tutorial after tutorial, but you're not really understanding it. And there's a reason why you feel that lack of confidence, or that you're not earning an income from coding or becoming a freelancer or a self-taught developer. Now, if you start building your own projects and you learn as you go and you take away that fear of the unknown and stop waiting to just learn all this crap, now you're gonna be in a really amazing position, my friend, and you're gonna be learning faster than you ever have. You're gonna internalize all that information, be able to apply it to your projects, and that way you're not wasting any time, because most of our time is wasted, honestly, learning lots of tutorials, going through lots of books, but not applying it. How I can relate this to chess is I had this really good friend, his name is Adil, I love that guy, but what he would do a lot is he would intimidate me with his knowledge of like chess, okay? So he'd be like, hey, I learned Sicilian Accelerated Hypermodern Dragon, and in this book that I'm going through, I'm learning The End Games by Tversky, and I'm learning this stuff, and I'm going through Reassess Your Chess by Jeremy Silliman, and I'm like, what the hell's going on? You know, I'm like, this guy knows way too much stuff. But I was playing more chess games than him. I was going to more tournaments actively than him. What ended up happening? My rating actually improved faster than him. And I love him to death. He was actually in California. Right now I'm in Miami on a beach, which is pretty cool. But I was in California in LA, and he came there and we were on a jet ski. So I still love him. He's still one of my best friends. But you know, when it came to chess, I was able to improve faster, and the reason why that happened was because I was playing more actively. Okay, so he knew all this theory and knowledge, but I actually had a stronger rating, right? But then he applied himself to the gym, and I was learning more theory there, and he's way stronger. His squat is like 300 pounds, and my one rep max is like, you know, 215 pounds. Now, coming back to coding, the coding world, if you are just learning and learning theory and going to tutorials and learning recursion, going through books, but you're not working on your own projects, it's really unfortunate, but you're gonna kinda suck. You're gonna be able to be in a room and hold a conversation. You're gonna sound and feel smart. You're gonna feel like you can judge other people, but probably not gonna have a job. You're probably not gonna have an awesome portfolio. You're probably not gonna have a lot of projects to show for it, and you're actually gonna have a much weaker skill set. So unless that knowledge is applied, it's useless. But if you wanna become better at soccer, and I just start teaching you on a whiteboard, and I'm like, so this is how you kick, and this is the best way to kick, and theoretically, if you kick at a 45 degree angle, this shit's gonna get lit. That's not gonna help you, and you're not gonna improve, right? But the way that you are gonna improve is if you actually go and just play with your friends, fuck up a lot, make a lot of mistakes, and then look up something, right? And then look up, okay, how can I improve my passing? Or how can I improve? Then you're gonna get a lot better. So this is my message for you. Shout out to Chris Hawks for commenting on the channel. Thank you for that awesome thing and support. Thank you everybody else who's on this channel and supporting it. At this point, I love your face off, but I do wanna say, in the comments below, let me know what you think about becoming a self-taught developer. I'm jumping in and responding to almost every single person right now. I'm very active. So if you wanna jump in and ask me a question, you know, this is something when people are consulting with me, they're paying me $500 an hour or more. So if you jump in and ask me questions, I'll be more than happy to actually answer, and you'll have me, you know, one-on-one there. So jump in and tell me your thoughts on becoming a self-taught developer. It's okay if you disagree with me. Doesn't matter, but jump in, drop something, give me your thoughts on this video or becoming a self-taught developer. Other than that, thank you so much for watching. I love your face, and as always, I'll see you in the next video.
So I have launched my new program called Earn 1K with Python. This is a brand new program. I've had so many students tell me, Kazi, please make something that is awesome, that's something that we can afford, and something that most of the students can have and get started with. Something that's more towards beginners, and also people who wanna get their first step and make their first $1,000 from programming. Because there are a lot of programmers I know who are pretty damn good, but they still haven't made their first $1,000, and they don't know what's a repeatable system to get high level mentorship, high level job opportunities, internships. How do they get those freelancing deals that most people don't know about, but there's a world of developers that knows about them, right? Why is there a difference between broke programmers, programmers who know a thing or two, who know how they can generate an income from this field. Most programmers are broke, but I wanna show you ways where you can cut down the trial and error, because it's the most expensive way to learn. And I have an incredible video that I want you to go and see that I've put together, okay? This video is unbelievable. This video will show you how I went from being a dumb, broke Oakland Community College student to making $104,000 a year as a developer. I've put together a video for you that will show you not only that, but it'll show you how you can leverage my hacks, my morning routine hacks, my strategies to essentially supercharge and 10x your productivity and effectiveness as a developer. And this video will also show you how to break past the barriers of procrastination and build more structure and discipline, because that's one of the things that people lack. But most importantly, this video will show you how you can earn your first $1,000 from programming and coding as a Python developer. And this is the biggest barrier. And once people cross it, it helps them learn a lot faster. It helps them commit to programming more. It helps them put more hours into it. And it helps them cut, you know, many years of taking a lot longer, and it gets them there a lot faster. So that's one of the biggest things that people don't know about. But if you can start earning an income from coding as fast as possible, you're gonna be in a position, you're gonna be in a pretty awesome position, all right? So please go watch this video. It's an epic video I've put together. Click on the link below in the description and it's gonna take you to it. With that said, thank you so much for watching. As always, I love your face, and I'll see you in that other video. So go click there. I'll see you right there. Click there. Do it. Do it. Do it. Do it. Ah!